Hello and welcome back to Survival Existence. What if I told you the contents in this little plastic tote could make your life much easier during a power outage? Would you believe me? In just a minute, I'll be back to show you how to turn your vehicle into a generator. Welcome back. The items pictured can make life much easier during a power outage. Starting with the bottom left is a couple of power splitters, a rope light, two extension cords, a couple of flashlights, four different LED light bulbs, two lanterns, and a power inverter. Your power inverter will determine how much you can actually run. These items will allow you to have enough power to be able to perhaps keep a refrigerator running every once in a while to keep it cool, but more important than that, will allow you some lighting and enough power for a very small television or radio to be able to keep up with what is happening during a disaster. In just a minute, I'll show you how it all hooks up and how it functions. Before we begin talking about how to attach a power inverter to your vehicle, let's discuss safety. Never ever run your vehicle inside an enclosed garage, even with your garage door open. Carbon monoxide tends to seek out an enclosed, confined space, such as inside your home. Always, when running your vehicle to produce power or even just warming it up during the winter, please back your vehicle at least halfway out into the open air so that carbon monoxide can freely escape into the atmosphere. Okay, the first thing we will do is attach our power inverter to our battery of our vehicle. This is a 410 watt Schumacher power inverter. It has two outlets and one USB connector for charging telephones and various other electronic pieces of equipment. Whenever you are using one of these in your running vehicle, always mount it to something that is large enough that it cannot fall over into the engine compartment and become entangled into the belts or the cooling fan. These inverters also come with a cigarette lighter plug. Do not use that plug on these inverters. They can produce far more power than the cigarette lighter socket can provide, so always use the wires with the clips on it. Once you clip it up to your engine, put it in a stable area in your engine compartment. Make sure it can't go anywhere. It should be ready to go. I'm going to test it to make sure the connections are good. If it's good, this green light will come on. And the red light come on and went off. It tells me that it's well connected. I'm going to turn that off right now. The next item we will connect is an extension cord into one of the receptacles. But notice we're leaving the inverter off. We don't want a sudden surge. Drawing from our pile of equipment, we will take one of these power splitters and plug it into the extension cord. That way we have three outlets that we can plug various lights and other equipment, even a modem and router, if you have enough power. Into this power splitter, we will then plug in the string lights. These string lights use very low wattage, and you can string them from room to room to provide light in several rooms with one string of lights. After that, with lamps inside the house, whatever lamps you want to power, whether they're in bedrooms, living rooms, dens, or kitchen, you simply plug these in. And then you choose an LED light. These LED lights are 2.5 watts. That's all they draw. And the reason I say use an LED light bulb is that a 100 watt light bulb actually draws 100 watts, and it's actually a waste of power. These little lights will produce a fair amount of light, and they only use 2.5 watts. So you could run, what, around 40, 35 or 40 lights for what one 100 watt light bulb would normally use in power. At this point, you should have routed your extension cord in to your house through an open window. All you have to do is simply lay a towel down on the window sill of the open window, run the power cord through, and then put a towel on top of it and push the window down on it. That'll keep from shorting your extension cord. And now to turn the switch on. As you see, the rope lights came on, and I'll turn the switch on for the lamp. That wasn't difficult, and it only took a few minutes. If you'll notice, I also keep a couple of flashlights and a couple of battery-powered lanterns inside this particular kit. It's because I use it as a blackout kit. It is very difficult to fumble around in the dark. Even during the daytime, when a severe storm comes through, it gets quite dark, and it's very difficult to find the items you need. Therefore, I strongly suggest that you keep it in a plastic tote, and also keep a couple of flashlights and some lanterns handy for being able to find all your equipment as you need it and be able to hook it up. Also, with vehicle batteries, they are not designed to be drawn down very much at all. They are not like a deep cycle battery you'll find on a boat. It's designed to run down and be charged up, run down, be charged up numerous times. A vehicle battery normally cannot take between 10 and 15 times of being discharged and recharged before the battery is damaged so severely that it's no longer useful. At this point, this 410-watt Schumacher power inverter is using approximately 7 to 8 watts for the rope lighting and 2.5 watts for the lamp. You add all that together and you still have plenty of room for more items, such as a small television. And I'm not talking about one of the older type televisions. I'm talking about a very small, low wattage television so that you can actually see what is going on around you if the disaster has occurred. You can also plug in your radio. There's plenty of room. While this power inverter will certainly not run your furnace in your house to keep you warm, or an air conditioner to keep you cool, or your central heat and air unit for that matter, it will still provide enough energy for you to be able to have light to see, and for you to be able to keep in touch with media, whether it's by the internet, if it isn't down, or television or radio, to keep apprised of any developing situations around you. When you're using your power inverter off of your vehicle's battery, remember to start your vehicle occasionally to keep the battery charged up. It's not good for the battery for it to be run down very much. This has been Bobby with Survival Existence. Please subscribe to our YouTube channel, like and share our video, like and share us on Facebook, and visit our website at survivalexistence.com. Thank you for watching.